Hi guys, welcome to this video. It's your boy Kunle Ologun. So the COVID has still not gone away. Currently, we have the US, Brazil, and India topping the chart on the most infected countries in the world. In fact, Spain has recently experienced high increase in infection as well.
A welcome break on a beach in Catalonia after an unprecedented lockdown would be difficult for most people to resist. But amid these relaxed scenes, an uncomfortable question is being asked. Is this the start of a second wave of the pandemic? On Saturday, almost 1,500 new cases were recorded in the region, most of them in and around the city of Barcelona. Many of the new cases are young people showing mild or no symptoms at all. It prompted a swift shutdown of nightclubs throughout the region, as well as a curfew on bars.
Xavi Hernandez, Spanish football giant legend, has been infected with COVID-19.
Barcelona legend Xavi tests positive for coronavirus. Barcelona legend and current Al Sadd coach Xavi confirmed Saturday that he has tested positive for coronavirus. The Qatari club announced via Twitter that the 40-year-old is feeling well but will isolate until he is given the green light to return.
Also, the UK authority has now announced that anyone arriving from Spain will have to self-isolate for 2 weeks.
Anyone arriving in the UK from Spain now has to self-isolate for 2 weeks after quarantine rules changed overnight.
It follows a sharp rise in Spanish coronavirus infections. Travel plans for thousands of Britons have been thrown into chaos.
Although we could go on the holidays, we booked holidays, we can't come back and then stay in the house for 2 weeks. That just wouldn't be possible.
But for some holidaymakers, there's relief at landing home late last night before the restrictions kicked in.
It was crazy. It all happened so quickly. No one knows what's going on in there. It's mad,
isn't it? Yeah, we're supposed to come back on Monday and we just got the next flight.
Also, the UK has announced that from the 24th of July, face masks will be compulsory in UK shops, supermarkets, and public transport.
To wear one or not?
Can be of benefit. So we're saying to people, wear them in shops and wear them on public transport.
Face masks will have to be worn in shops, supermarkets, shopping centres and transport hubs. Refusing to wear a mask when you should could land you with a £100 fine. The rules will not apply to children under 11 and people with certain disabilities or health conditions.
So clearly, we still have a lot to do in ensuring that we maintain the social distancing, we observe all health guidance across our countries, and make sure that the spread of COVID-19 reduces. Hopefully, Spanish authority will continue to look into this and see ways to ensure that the second wave does not ravage the country totally and cripple its economy. Okay, moving on. So just last week, I reported the case of a Nigerian combat helicopter pilot, Tolulope Arotile, who died a senseless death in Nigeria Air Force Base in Kaduna, Nigeria. She is now being buried. Watch her in this video.
Who walk uprightly
and stared into the Nigerian Defense Academy, Kaduna, as a member of 64th Regular Course.
Because of their trust and investment, Tolulope showed exemplary skills too difficult to emulate. As a child, Tolulope had always dreamed of flying a plane. At that age, her aspirations were blurry. But today, we can gladly all testify to the impact she has made, not only in the Nigerian Air Force, but among family members, friends, colleagues, and the entire nation. Tolulope, aside work, loved God, and his love was second to none.
Man born of the woman has the suffer to this.
Evidence. So, off the back of this barrier, there has been a number of growing concerns about the cause of her death. In fact, here in UK, there was a protest that the Nigerian authority need to investigate the cause of her death. Watch the protest in this video.
Here we're saying, we demand an autopsy now, an independent autopsy. We demand an independent autopsy. We need to know what happened. We are no longer satisfied with a failed governance that even as we speak yesterday, they shut down four different protests that was going to happen in Oyo, Ekiti, Ogun and Eko. They shut it down because they did not want the people's voice to be heard. Ladies and gentlemen, I ask you, is that a democracy?
No!
Is that a democracy?
No!
Is that a democracy?
No!
The least we want from this government is to give us an independent autopsy assessment.
Yes!
And a proper report, yes, that will tell us how Tolulope Arotile died.
Also, in Nigeria, there has been a growing concern about why the death has not been thoroughly investigated.
Tolulope Arotile bon ton ba bi mo igba omo ki kan kan omo sin
ase
bo ba bi igba omo ki kan kan omo gbeyin e
ase
omo kan soso ta nwo ni yi ni yen ni le yoruba Tolulope Arotile tui omo igbogbo eda keda to ba mo nipa ku e gbogbo eda be ko mo mo sin won
ase
won na ri dam
ase
ile won mo gbona
ase
iwo ogun lakaye gbogbo eda keda eyan keyan to mo npa ku Tolulope Arotile omo binrin kan soso ti o je ti yoruba tan wo pe irawo kan re nile yoruba eyan kan si pa ni fona fonsu idamu ko mo jina le eni
ase
idamu ko mo jina si le eni
ase
iru eni be to ba bi gba omo kikan omo sin
ase
ori be ko se be
ase
ka do ati wa ko gba
ase
iya Tolulope ati baba re won bi won wa so ni Tolulope won bi omo yen won so ni Maria iya Jesus won so lo ko tin be nu Qur'ani awo ti le yen awon baba ti wa won mo so mo be awon baba ti wa nle ni baba wa awon mo so mo be ko le sele sa usa ka uzo dabe bi ibo se ni gaga to pe ajo wa ni le fun kan na ti ibo yi ibo ni gba omo yi ni omo obirin akoko omo 23 years to wa to lo si oju ogun boko haram to ja to segun to pada wale to jo omo yoruba to wa o be woni yoruba fe ele won ti wa wo fun to omo yen pe omo yi o ja kikan ju omo fun yoruba won wa pa won wa lawon fun yoruba si oko pa e wa gba mi yoruba si oko se e to wa moto yen se rifasi tin gbe bo yen se 20 kilometers lo n ba bo ni abi 100 kilometers lo n ba bo pelu rifasi eyin o wa eyin lo mo yen wa bi rin pade rifasi abe ri joka o to sele yi gbogbo awon baba wa to e kon dide kon dupo kon jade lori to sele yi o le soro awon mo kekeke kan to wa dide kon na fe awon be ka kiri e ma ko po ko jade ton ba jade e pa wa e yibon e si gba ka lo gba order ka lo gba se ngba ti awon on black guy back on to je omo dudu ton pa America se awon to se wode yen se won lo gba se lowo Trump won to wode ko to pomo yen ko to pa ko to dobi omo yen rogodo omo lomo to njo ogunde o sun sinu le won de pe jade won de pomo yen awa fe jade pe ohun ton se a fe wadi ton fun wa ni video ton se pa omo yen ke se pa la fe ba eja a la fe dalu a la fe se kankan a la fe se peaceful rally ye rally jeje ka kan fe onu wa ka kan gbe black card si ni joba ologun a wa ni joba alagbada.
So clearly these Nigerians are also planning protests across the country to make sure that the government thoroughly investigate the true cause of this death. Hopefully, the Nigerian government will listen to these protesters and they will see reason why it is really important to establish the true cause of the death and show to the Nigerian people that this is not got anything to do with anyone speculating anything anywhere. Probably the Hausas killing the Yorubas, as some people are speculating, because they saw the future of this lady, that she's going to rise to the top at some point, and they quickly, you know, murdered her. So this really need to be cleared by the Nigerian government, that this is not the case, if truly that is not the case. Hopefully, this will be resolved in no distance time. So moving on to our weekly money transfer update. We can see on this slide that there has been a number of changes this week. All of our money transfer companies have significantly increased their rate to Nigeria for this week, which is a really good sign. If you look at the top, Aboki FX, which is the standard rate that all of these money transfer companies should be using, is also gone up as well. From the top, Aboki FX in itself is recorded 570 naira to a pound. This is a massive increase. So topping our list for this week, it remains Azimo. Azimo has significantly increased their rate to Nigeria. 1 pound to naira on Azimo is 505 naira. So this is significant increase from the previous week of 493 that was reported. Also, in terms of euro, we can see that Azimo has gone up as well from 448 all the way to 458. Azimo is not currently available in the United States of America and some other part of the world, as we can see on this table. We can see Ace, who is currently occupying the two position on this table. Ace is gone up as well from 485 as at last week to 489 for this week for 1 pound to naira, as we can see. In terms of euro, we can see Ace has also gone up to 445, and Ace is also not available in the United States of America. We can see number three on our list is TransferWise. Ria is fourth on our list, and we can see MoneyGram, WorldRemit, and SendWave. For this week, SendWave has increased their rate to Nigeria from 470 naira to 477 naira to a pound. We can also see that SendWave has increased their euro to Nigeria as well. In terms of dollars, SendWave is still currently reporting 382 naira to $1, as they reported last week. So there has not been significant changes in terms of the dollars, but we can see that there has been significant changes in terms of the pounds and euro from all of these money transfer companies. So as I said last week, I will continue to bring you up to speed with the current best rate every week, so that you can sit back and relax and you take that decision on which money transfer company you use to send money to your families across the world. Hopefully, this video has helped someone today. Moving on, my inspirational quote for today is, words can inspire, thoughts can provoke, but only action truly brings you closer to your dreams. Take action today, Brad Sugars. If you have not subscribed to our channel on YouTube, please kindly do so. As I said several times, we still have a lot of videos coming your way. Thank you so much for watching this video today, and bye for now.